6, going dark.
Hey everybody, my name is Luke and I'm an NVG flight instructor here at SUU Aviation. Today I want to go over what night vision in a helicopter is like and why we teach it to all of our rotor students. As the name implies, wearing NVG or night vision goggles allows you to see in the dark. So how does that work? Well, these goggles use photocathodes, photomultipliers, and a phosphor screen that works together to convert the light photons into an image that you can see. NVGs heavily depend on celestial illumination, so that's light from the moon and the stars while we fly. Ideal conditions for NVG would be a full moon and clear skies. We can still safely fly with zero moon, it just doesn't have the same level of detail. When wearing the goggles on a full moon, it actually looks like the sun, and you can see the shadows of the mountains, trees, and even the helicopter. In truth, night vision takes getting used to. It limits your field of view from 200 degrees to 40 degrees, and messes with your depth perception a lot. This is especially apparent in things like takeoffs, approaches, off airports, and EPs. For example, biggest challenges students have is coming in shallow on an approach, because through the goggles it looks normal. Hovering for the first time under NVGs will make you think you're hovering 5 feet off the ground, when actually you could be hovering up to 30 feet off the ground. It takes training to get used to, and is especially crucial when doing off airports and emergency procedures. Along with that, you can't even look at your instruments directly while wearing the NVGs. You have to position your head in a way so where you can see underneath your goggles. You might be wondering, if I have instruments and lights, then why do I need NVG? Well, on a night like tonight, when the moon hasn't risen yet, we won't be able to see that mountainous terrain. There are several kinds of rotor jobs that use it. NVG is typically used by EMS, law enforcement, search and rescue, and the military. It's often used to help find people in isolated areas. With helicopters, we have the ability to fly and land in places where there's no visible light. The part of your training in which you do NVG is done in your instrument lab, and you'll get about 10 hours as an intro. There's also an NVG lab, which is 20 hours. So why is the light white? You might be familiar with all those army commercials and video games that shows night vision goggles glowing green. That's because in the military, standard issue NVG goggles use green phosphor. What we actually use is white phosphor, which gives you the ability to see in greater detail. What happens if you look at light while under NVG? Night vision is not on all the time. They're on a mount that goes to the battery pack, and we have to flip the goggles down for them to turn on. If it's on and you look at a light that is too bright, you could temporarily impair your vision, which is obviously really important to have as a pilot, and it could potentially damage the phosphor that's in the goggles. We ensure that we send our goggles out for inspection regularly. In fact, each goggle has their own airworthiness certificate and current NVG certificate. You can't just take goggles and hop into any aircraft. The aircraft has to be specifically outfitted with things such as filters on the gauges, radar altimeter, and nav light covers we have on our Robinsons, so the light doesn't shine into the cabin. Several of our birds are NVG compatible. In order to get your NVG PIC endorsement, you need to get trained by an instructor endorsed as a night vision goggle instructor. Some of the training you will do in NVG is approaches, off airports, and emergency procedures, such as straightened autos, 180 autos, hover autos, and governor failures. It's kind of like a mini stage or check ride. I hope you have found this video helpful. If you'd like to see our other rotor training videos, feel free to click on a video at the end, and don't forget to subscribe.